Hello, very good evening to all of you. Very warm welcome to our next series, next lecture series on the topic of art and craft of India. And today we have a very interesting topic. We have very interesting topic, and our delegate madam is also there. So very warm welcome to madam. And we have one more guest.
Thank you.
Dr. Jeetu Sharkia, sir. Very warm welcome to you, sir.
Thank you.
At this outset, I must remembering some lines. I must remembering some line from an artist corner. Yes, I am an artist. I am a creator of ideas, swimming in a sparkling sea of imagination, a magician of shorts, turning thoughts of wonderment into pieces of originality. Each creation showcases my own personal journey. My worries, dreams, and ambitions, everything I love and everything I hate, everything I fear, all that I was yesterday and all that I will be tomorrow, is neatly contained in my glorious creations. When you play over my work, you are catching a glimpse of my soul. For a part of me is in each piece I create. I march to my own beat and weirdly dance to my own rhythm. Passion runs through my veins as emotions are fuel for my craft. Certain pieces I protect and keep to myself, while others I will share with the world. I am a creative beacon, shining my light brightly for all the universe to see. I am all these things and more, rolled into one amazingly talented, unique artist. Yes, of course, a unique artist can do anything, whatever that emotions, that whatever the feelings, the artist can only express their feelings and all, everything over the work, over their work and all. So an artist can do. So with these lines, if I'm telling about something like paintings and all our art and crafts of India, as we have done so many lectures on the theme like heritage of India. Then yesterday we have handloom of India lecture with Professor Montu Boshak, and then again on the theme, today's theme is art and craft of India. Yes, I welcome Mr. Oknimil Das, our youth officer, RD. Most welcome in our program. So, passed down from one generation to another, Indian folk art is still alive in many parts of the country. Being culturally diverse and distinct, a variety of art forms have enrolled over the years. Some untouched by modernization, some adapting to new paint colors and materials. Each depict religions, epics or gods and goddesses mostly, but they are all unique, admirable and imitable in their own might. In the days of yore, they were made with natural dyes and colors made of soil, mud, leaves and charcoal on canvas or cloth, giving it a sense of antiquity. Vintage nostalgia. Yes. Then today we have madam taking over the charge on that. She will deliver her lecture on Tanzor painting. It's a very rare actually. In India, folk art, folk painting forms are like 10. There are 10 types of paintings in India. Those are recognized as folk paintings. Yes, like Madhubani, miniature paintings, pad, varli, kon, kalamkari, cherial scrolls, Kalighat paintings, Pattachitra, and Tanjore paintings. So today we have a talk on Tanjore paintings. Tanjore paintings if I say what is Tanjore Paintings, this madam is there, she will deliver her talk and the topic. So Tanjore Paintings originated in 1600 AD, encouraged by the Nayakas of Tanjore. It can be recognized by its gold foil, which glitters and lends the painting a surreal look. These panel paintings on wooden planks depict devotion to gods, goddesses, and saints. It borrows its styles from Maratha and Deccan art as well as European style as well. So these are some lines for me. And ma'am, you are there. Now I would like to request Mr. Ognibil Das. Sir, please, if you want to say something on the topic.
Thank you very much. আমাকে আবার বলতে দেওয়ার জন্য
দু লাইন
না না আমি এটাই আমার না এই বিষয়ে জ্ঞান খুবই সীমিত কিন্তু আমি আমাদের ম্যাডাম গৌরীবালা ম্যাডামকে ধন্যবাদ জানাই থ্যাংক ইউ ভেরি মাচ ম্যাডাম ফর জয়নিং টুডেস ইনভাইটেশন ফ্রম আওয়ার এনএসএস ইউনিট অফ বঙ্গবাসী মর্নিং কলেজ আর থ্যাংক ইউ টু ডক্টর সুলেখা চক্রবর্তী ম্যাডাম ওয়ান্স এগেইন ফর organizing another golden jubilee lecture series. Madam have planned to stop it by 12, but that I have just mentioned to Mehuli sometimes ago that there is another program and Madam should be ready to have it. That is the commemorament of 150th year of Mahatma Gandhi. So I think we will get another program from Bangabashi Morning College. But regarding today's program, I want to thank once again the College of Trinity for organizing such event one after one. And thank you very much to the resource person and eminent personalities that who are present here. Thank you very much. And wish a best program for today. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for being with us always, for motivating us always. So now I would like to request our volunteer Ishita Mukherjee to give some light on the topic, on the theme, and she has created a video, a nice video she will show. So Ishita, please.
Yes ma'am.
The dice is yours now. Yes, Ishita.
With a history that's rich in culture and heritage, India is a treasure trove of art forms that have been passed down from one generation to another. I will create a video and that will show the form, the Tanjavur art form. Please, Chandan, can you please present this video? Chandan?
Yes, he is presenting.
Indian art may be well said to bear in itself the amalgamation of spirituality, sensuality, symbolism, and reality from the prehistoric to the present era. Painting is one of the most delicate forms of art, giving expression to human thoughts and feelings through the media of line and color. It reflects the diverse culture and heritage of the country. Tanjore painting is a popular form of artwork that originated in South India. These paintings have been popular from 16th century and have evolved under the reign of the Chola emperors and are famous for its use of gold. When the Marathas invaded Tanjore in Tamil Nadu, many painters and artists migrated here, and under their rule, this art form flourished. This form of painting is distinguished by its use of gold and semi-precious or precious stones, which is used to accentuate the design. Each painting tells a story, usually revolving around Hindu gods, goddesses, and saints. In the olden days, Tanjore paintings were placed in the dark temples, shrines by the emperors. In a dim place, the gold used to enhance the painting. Tanjore paintings are completely handmade and do not employ any machinery. To make a Tanjore painting, a sketch is first made on a cloth. This cloth is pasted on a wooden base historically made from the jackfruit tree. Today, plywood is used as an alternative. The canvas is evenly coated with limestone or French chalk and binding medium. Once dry, the sketch is outlined with dark brown or black paint and painted using bright colors. In olden days, vegetable or mineral dyes were used in the painting. The colors used were specific to different segments of the painting. For example, backgrounds were usually red or green. Lord Vishnu was colored blue and Lord Nataraj was painted white. The color yellow was used to paint goddess. The sky was painted blue or black depending on the story. The clothing and ornaments adorned by god and goddess were made of pure gold. Gold, gemstones, pearls, glass beads and precious stones are embossed over the painting. This gave the painting a three-dimensional effect. Usually gold foils are used in these paintings. Sometimes pure gold milk or dust is used as well. The use of pure gold makes the painting a splendid visual treat. Since gold was widely used, these paintings were considered a treasure. The shine of these paintings lasts for 8 to 100 years as pure gold never fades. The most loved theme by Thanjavur painters has been the image of the baby Krishna sitting on his golden throne with a pot of butter in his hand. He is elaborately bejeweled and the painting features gold in his jewelry, clothing and the throne. Forms of Thanjavur paintings specific to respective regions, like the Chettinad Thanjavur painting originated in Thanjavur, the Mysore Thanjavur painting originated in Mysore. Today, the paintings are almost the same, but the materials used have been upgraded to keep up the modern times. The Thanjavur art form exists in various reigns and various regions, with each having their own unique interpretation. These paintings continue to be made even to the present day, though not with the rigor and the virtuosity that marked the painting of yore. Revival programs, exhibitions, workshops, and training camps of Thanjavur paintings are being held regularly by the many institutions, include state governments. The materials used have also changed according to the cost, ease of the availability, and the choice of individual artists. Plywood, for the example, has by and large replaced jack and teak wood. Synthetic colors and additives are preferred over the natural and the mineral colors and other traditional components. Mug powder, a fine powder of chalk, is used to create a 3D effect in the paintings. In addition to the traditional subjects, a wide range of popular and modern subjects and themes are being depicted in Thanjavur paintings. While it is a happy development that its traditional art continues to hold its sway, the brazen commercialization and the lack of aesthetics are disturbing trends. Be that as it may, Thanjavur paintings, the style and the aesthetics continue to inspire many contemporary artists. The calendar prints of C. Kondia Raju and his students' followers, marked by an iconic solidness as against the Western naturalism of Raja Ravi Verma, as example of the continued influence of Thanjavur paintings in modern popular and academic art. Artists have taken this old form of art and over the years combined it with other styles to create mixed media arts. For example, Thanjavurs are also done on mirrors, glass and canvas. The idea of applying gold foil is unique to this traditional art. So this same style is taken and recreated on different mediums.
Thank you very much, Ishita. Yes. Ishita, you have done, yeah, well done, well done, Beta. You have done a lot, like, it's a very wonderful presentation you have made. Okay, most welcome, Ishita. And then now the time is here for, like, we have the domain today. We have the domain of this Thanjavur painting.
Yes, welcome, Ishita. And then now the time is here. Or like, we have the domain
okay.
today. We have the
good evening, everybody. Yes. Hello,
it's
the
time is there. Or like,
Ishita, please mute your mic. Ishita, please mute your mic.
Yes, ma'am, I just muted my mic.
Yes, yes.
Miholi?
Okay. Okay. No, I was just scared. What happened?
Yes, I had asked my grandson to be here in case of any tech problem.
Oh yeah. These are happening actually. These are the like online virtual classes. we all have to do so much of things like that. So yes. Now the time is there. I would like to invite Madam. Before that, I would like to introduce Madam first. Mrs. Gauri Madam, with a natural talent for drawing and painting combined with a passion for visual arts. Is mostly a self-taught artist, a native of Chennai. Post-marriage, she lived in Thanjavur, the birthplace of well-known Thanjavur style of art, for 3 decades. She had the opportunity to be associated with a research student in Thanjavur paintings and a renowned master, which enabled learning the process and the practices of this wonderful art form. With undaunted perseverance, she slowly but steadily mastered the nuances of this art form, always adhering to the traditional values. As a natural progression, she was transformed from being a student to a teacher and has initiated many art experiments into learning and practicing this ancient art form. Presently in Chennai, she has been training students for the past 12 years. With the aim of promoting and passing on the true value and essence of Thanjavur painting. Currently, she is a lead teacher and advisor at Vivekananda Cultural Center, a cultural unit of Sri Ramakrishna Mission, Chennai. Welcome, madam.
Thank you.
Welcome, madam. Please, the dice is yours now. Yes, most welcome, ma'am.
Namaskara. I am from Vivekananda Cultural Center, which is a unit of Sri Ramakrishna Mat, Chennai. Do you hear me, Tulika?
Yes, madam, we can.
Vivekananda Cultural Center is inside the Vivekananda Illam campus. That is where Swami Vivekananda stayed for 9 days when he visited Chennai on his way back from Chicago Street. The center has been conducting Thanjavur painting classes for the past 6 years. Many students come and learn the art in the traditional way, in the ideal ambience provided by the place. Today, I am very happy to be here sharing my thoughts on Thanjavur paintings, one of the great classical art forms of South India. Thank you for inviting me here today in this lecture series on art and craft. So, shall I start my presentation? Hello?
Yes, ma'am. Please start. Please carry on.
Present now for no Chrome tab. Chrome wants to share the contents. It is the name. Recent Google name. Tradition. Can you see?
Yes, madam.
Yeah, everything is fine, na?
Yes, madam.
Yeah. So, whatever I am sharing here are insights that I have gained going to my extended life in Tanjore and having contact with the people in the field. I hope I shall be able to present this content in a way to do full justice. Trying to learn the Tanjore painting during the late 1980s was not that easy. Either it was very expensive, but mostly no artist would divulge the secrets, either techniques involved or the finer aspects of coloring, etc. So it had been a very long journey for me, but I got exposed to the wonderful paintings spread across the many temples, personal possessions of friends, and got to see the paintings of the authentic style. Now, during the next 45 minutes or so, we will be discussing about Tanjore paintings with the topic of evolution, relevance, and the contemporary. This is the topic I have been given. And I intend sharing more on the history and the evolution of this beautiful art form, because only through them, better knowledge and values attached to them are passed on to the future generation. More and more people are attracted towards this painting. So it would be better for anyone who wants to seriously learn Tanjore paintings to be aware of its rich heritage. We will start discussing the evolution of visual art in the region in a brief manner, with a specific mention about Chola art, because they were the people who whose period it was called Golden Age of Tamil Nadu. So the mention about Chola art and the successive dynasties, then briefly about Tanjore, the place where this art form thrived during the Maratha period, before proceeding to the main topic of the contemporary issues. So, universally, art is considered to be a form of expression, and a form of expression of emotions and ideas through various mediums, and one such is the visual art. And art has been documented origins in caves and on rock surfaces made by the primitive man all over the world, including our great country, depicting everyday life. We have such works spread across the country, a few yet to be dated. Here in Tamil Nadu also they are doing that. Here we see the Bimbedkar rock paintings near Bhopal. And then from primitive to the age, starting from the ancient art period of Buddhist paintings, traditional Indian art originally was about the essence of a theme or a subject, and not physical realities. According to Swami Vivekananda, real art is idealism and not portraying realism. The purpose of Indian art largely has been to turn a person from worldly to spiritual, from material to the absolute. Thus, all Indian art forms had a spiritual foundation, something that had been handed down through generations. That culture reflected in the paintings. Thus, the entire heritage of art in India had been basically spiritual, and its aim, the portrayal of divinity. So we can classify Indian paintings according to the size. And if we do that, they can be broadly classified as murals and miniatures. We all know that murals are large works executed on walls of solid structures like the Ajanta or the beautiful Brahadeswara temple murals. Being the oldest form of art, these murals represent history also. each period in history has inspired the next. Miniatures are of smaller sizes according to the demands of time. When it comes to Thanjavur painting, anything, any size below 2 feet to 1 feet can be considered as miniatures. And also manuscripts of Ramayana, Mahabharata illustrations, they also come under this category. And style, if we take style into account, we can call the Indian paintings as classical and folk art form. And actually, the style of painting depicted the lifestyle of a particular region. Classical paintings are stylized versions of art renowned for their harmony, balance, and sense of proportion. Subjects come alive in rich colors and the composition in Thanjavur paintings, which we will be seeing more of later. The folk art form is the one of the oldest art forms, that's also one, with every region having its own style and patterns, which Tulika mentioned a lot, Varli, Madhubani, like that. They are very ethnic, simple, yet colorful and vibrant, depicting the major events of our day-to-day life. In this sense, we can very well say that the Thanjavur board paintings are classical miniatures. Here we see, Tulika Man said, Patachitra painting and Madhubani painting. They are folk art. Now we will see about the art forms directly or indirectly had an impact in the region and subsequently the evolution of this style of paintings. So according to Mr. Srinivas Rao, a scholar and a blogger, the Chola artists of the Brihadisura murals were the inheritors of a tradition of ancient texts. So we had texts as to how figures should be drawn, how the color should be done, how the composition should be made, everything. We had text. We'll talk or see about that later. They preserved and practiced the concepts of the techniques explained in that text. The delineation of lines, the use of colors, shapes, arrangements of the figures of the canvas and treatment of the subject strongly resembles the murals of Ajanta. He compares the murals of Brihadisura temple to Ajanta. We will see the picture later. Cholas were the forerunners of the region, executed by paintings, murals, starting from murals. Being the forerunners of execute paintings of the region for about 5 centuries, that is from 8 to 13, the Chola artist of Deccan created wonderful paintings and sculptures. With the decline of the Chola dynasty in the 13th, the Nayakas and then Marathas ruled the region. Chola murals of the Brihadisura temple were covered with Nayak paintings during repairs and renovations. Colonial period is the evolution from murals to miniatures. But starting from the rock and cave murals to the miniatures, these paintings became important in Indian history, with a value as works of art and examples of India's artistic heritage. When we talk about Thanjavur painting and Thanjavur, we need to talk about Cholas a bit more. Thanjavur is the place where the present form of Thanjavur paintings came to be. It had been an important center of religion, art and architecture. It became the most important city in the Chola Empire and remained its capital till roughly about the 10th century. It was also called the rice bowl of Tamil Nadu. The temple, culture, architecture of Thanjavur are famous throughout the world. It is a historical place ruled by the Cholas, then Pandyas, Nayakas, Marathas, and also under the British, under British rule till independence. The pursuits of these rulers are reflected in the grand monuments like Grand Aniket, Big Temple, Sarfoji Mahal, Palace and Saraswati Mahal Library in the district. And when we talk about Thanjavur, we need to mention that Brihadisura Temple, which is shortly called Big Temple. And it was built by Radharaja Chola. You can see him, his statue here. Being affluent, Tanjavur attracted so many emperors towards his territory. But the place attained the greatest eminence under the Cholas. And the king Radharaja Chola I was noteworthy because he is said to have built this temple. And the famous Brihadeeswara murals were found in this temple. Tanjavur continued to be the cultural center for the consecutive rulers also. Having great ancient temple built by these rulers, the place flourished with music, fine arts and literature. The traditional culture nurtured by statesmen, saints, scholars, musicians and artists. Kings being orthodox Hindus encouraged establishing mats which spread Bhakti tradition through music, art, etc. The art of painting also flourished thus and branched into many varieties through many mediums till the late 18th century. Thus, the region under Chola dynasty was described as the golden age of Tamil culture. This is the left, left is the Ajanta mural, and the other one is found on the Brihadeeswara temple wall. So that's what the blogger said, both similar. The next generation, they period artists, they derive their inspiration from the previous one. This is what is shown here. And after the fall of the Vijayanagara Empire, resulting in a migration of a particular community of artists called Rajus, speaking Telugu, to Tanjavur, Kalamkari style of art being one of the prevailing art styles of Andhra Pradesh, that is believed to be, Kalamkari or Kalahasti style of paintings of Tirupati might have been the predecessor for the later Tanjavur style. I mentioned about the text which describes the way everything should be drawn or painted. And we already saw that the migrating artists also brought with them certain tradition of paintings and sculptures. These were bound by the earlier Vedic tradition of Shilpa and Chitra Shastra. One such text is the Vishnu Dharmottara Purana. When we are talking about an Indian art form, we cannot forget to mention about this text. It was not known, well known those days, and even only for the past 6 or 7 years, it has been mentioned in the. It is being mentioned. This is an ancient. Atin, can you please disconnect that phone? You disturb her. One such text is the Vishnu Dharmottara Purana. When we are talking about an Indian art form, we cannot forget to mention about this text. This is an ancient subsidiary text for Vishnu Purana, and the part of Vishnu Dharmottara Purana deals with painting and image making. These artists chose subjects like presentation of Krishna Leela, Rama's coronation, and dance of Shiva, Ganesha, etc. as acceptable pictorial representations in murals and paintings. Characters were chosen from Puranas, Itihasas also were used as models. You can see the difference between the paintings showed by that Ishitar, and the paintings shown now. According to our Indian tradition and culture, and the artists who followed the tradition believe that painting is not just a technique of putting paint over a surface. It's a way of understanding and expressing your emotions about the life around you. It's a way of looking beyond the forms and appearances that meet the eye. And above all, it is about giving expression to a deeply spiritual experience that springs from the artist's very inner being. these two paintings, most of the paintings I show are very old, belong to 19th century, up to 19th century. And then absorbing the local artistic tradition and customs, the erstwhile Vijayanagar School of Painting gradually evolved into the many styles in South India, into Tanjavur and Mysore, and Vorayur or Srirangam styles, which predominantly showed the Tamilian style of jewelry and attires. Here you see the difference, the same subject, but the jewelry and the dress they wear, they look different. Tanjavur style mostly displayed the Marathi way of dresses and ornaments. And then the Mysore painting. This is almost similar to the Vorayur style, but with minor differences. And this style involved detailed painting work and less embossing work. The embossing means that girl told you make a portion raised and then fix gold foil over that. This is more like the miniature paintings of Rajasthan. See, Rajasthan miniature, we talk about that, but there are three, four styles, no? Basholi and Kangra. And also Patachitra has Orissa Patachitra and Bengali Patachitra. Like that, we have these different styles. The style of gem set paintings reached its peak during the Maratha period. While the Cholas and Nayakar murals were Shaivite themes, mostly the last rulers, Marathas brought a Vaishnavite element to the Tanjavur painting. Lord Krishna was and has been even now the most favored subject. Consequently, the literature and art fields emerged with innovative ideas and created many new forms with unique features. The old paintings, even now, are available at various palaces and ancestral homes of people of Tanjavur, speaking the glory of the art. Like that girl said, Tanjavur paintings are said to lighten up a dark room. Originally decorated with gemstones and gold sheets, Tanjavur paintings were affordable only to the rich and the royal. They were displayed in temples and largely patronized by the king and nobles. They made paintings of the chosen deities studded with precious stones and pure gold. These paintings adorned the palaces and mansions with the sole purpose of worshipping. The Bhakti movement gave a huge impetus to the art and culture of India. Gradually, wall murals in temples and palaces evolved into portable shrines so that people can have it at home. People also wanted statue-like paintings, leading to the three-dimensional effect or the embossed look, especially for mandapams, jewelry, seat of the deities, and at times even for the dress also. This is one of the portable shrines with picturing Guru Nanak flanked by his devotees. Art spread across religions. This is also another painting with Shiva seated on the Rishabha with his consort Parvati, and there are more added characters of devotees around the main subject as well as on the door panel. Another form is the large murals evolved into was the painting on boards, originally called Palagai Padams in Tanjavur, Tamil. That is meaning painting on a wooden panel. This fulfilled the need for icons to worship at homes. Colonial period brought more surfaces, more other than wood, also to be used as canvas. Like we heard earlier, glass paintings. The paintings are made on glass. Glass paintings was one artwork which came about as part of the European influence. The same subjects which were done on a board were done on a glass and were affordable too, but they had the drawback of breaking. These paintings were very popular and the aim was providing devotional images for the middle class puja rooms. We can say that it continues to be popular even today. For weddings and events, they gift, they can be bought in a small size. So they gift it, they are popular even today. Many don't know about the glass paintings of Tanjavur. Due to the commercialization of art, with the coming of the British rule and paintings were done on mica sheets, playing cards. Because when Europeans come and to visit and they want to go back, they wanted to take souvenirs from India. So these mica paintings, they were portable, easy to carry. So they carried home as souvenirs. These are the playing cards, otherwise called Gajnipa cards. Now, at present, these arts are being revived. That's very encouraging to see. Up to a certain period of time, Kanju paintings are faithful to the injections and rarely stayed beyond the texts that I mentioned about. During the times of the East India Company, that is in the between 18th and 19th century, paintings were done by the Indian artists commissioned by the foreigners who were fascinated by the environment here. So the artists were asked to illustrate the customs, traditions of India, as also the deities, monuments, etc. These were called company paintings. The British and Victoria Albert Museums in England house a large collection of Tanjavur paintings, the company of traditional paintings. Though these British patronage paintings tend to be grouped under the company style of paintings, they were Tanjavur paintings in spirit, Tanjavur paintings in spirit. In addition to being executed by the same traditional group of artists in Tanjavur and the neighboring region, the style and characterization in these paintings are very typically Tanjavur. They are distinct from the company paintings executed in Calcutta. Calcutta also company paintings were done. The Tanjavur style company paintings are distinct from which were made in Calcutta or Lucknow. Again, when we talk about Tanjavur painting, we have to mention the king, Raja Sarpoji. He was the Maratha king. During the beginning of 19th century, he ruled. He was a great ruler, but came to the throne with a British help. And there was some treaty. Due to the treaty, he could not rule. He didn't have any power to rule. So instead, what he did was he made his court the center of culture and literary activities. He collected a great number of books and established a proper place to arrange and display them. Now it is called Saraswati Mahal Library. It is very famous, which is another important landmark in Tanjavur. These are the manuscript paintings he made. He also had many ancient texts copied and illustrated with paintings on wood and paper. These manuscripts, they were loose pages, and so he arranged to make the painted illuminations and decorations on the opening page of a chapter or volume of Rig Veda, Ramayana and Mahabharata. Though the small wooden cover paintings surpass the paper illustrations in their compositions, color and workmanship, even though the subjects are iconic. Now we are coming to Tanjavur paintings. Like other Indian forms of this style, this painting was named after the place of its origin and growth. Features Each of our traditional paintings reflect how the artist perceived everything around them, which they combined with their ideas and imagination and created paintings. So all traditional paintings shared a few common features and also had their own unique features. We'll see what the features are, common as well as unique. Surface. Actually, jackfruit trees being abundant and easily available in that region, its plants were used for the base. They were naturally termite-free and was most suited for such prolonged and elaborate process of the painting. And tamarind seed paste was boiled into a natural adhesive. And like all traditional Indian artists, before the commercially produced color mediums came into vogue, the artists were using natural colors. The process of making these colors were tedious, but they were brilliant. When painted, they were brilliant. The pigments were ground with natural gum from neem tree, at times wood apple tree, and which was fragrant, and filtered to make a fine, smooth paste. These were stored in coconut shells, and then basic colors of red, yellow, blue, as in any other traditional painting, and white, they were made, and from which all other shades, lighter, darker, they were prepared. The unique feature, one of the unique features of these paintings is they are surrealistic. As I mentioned earlier, it's a way of looking beyond the forms and appearances that meet the eye and creating a figure from memory. Those days, they didn't use models, live models. These artists followed austerity and approached the creation of a painting with reverence. Characters were iconic and composition static. But in spite of a lack of movement and emotions, these paintings made a grand and soul-satisfying impact in the minds of the worshipper, as also satisfy the components of the idols of a puja room or a temple. The main subject was always larger and in the center. All the other characters were placed at the appropriate places with the respective size related to their position and status with regard to the main character. Many elements, small and big, were added to fill the space in a harmonious manner. Just see at the bottom of the Bhatra Krishna, we see a cow. The cow is not of that size. This is surrealistic and filling the space. And also, in the earlier examples of paintings, the gold work was restricted to the decoration of the deity or the shrine and occupied only a small portion of the picture area. Later on, the gold decorations increased, and now we find that the entire painting is being ornamented with excessive intricate work, giving it an overly look. The focus now is more on the commercial rather than the aesthetic value. Earlier, since organic raw materials were used and preservative methods were many of the old paintings, they lasted for centuries. And learning, it was not a crash course. Learning was only through apprenticeship, as in any other Indian learning of art or craft of olden days. People mostly trained under a master till they completely understood the concepts and methods before becoming independent. Portraiture. Actually, talking about the ancient era paintings, Sri Srinivas Rao, he says that his blogger, there has been a marked absence of realistic portraits in the ancient periods. See, we have to know all this. We do not know many of the things like this. One rarely comes across the physical representation of the monarchs or the patrons who caused the paintings to be done. This could be viewed as one of the strengths of Indian art. It strived to move away from the ephemeral towards the long-lasting and from particular to universal. It also meant that the ancient Indian kings were not vain enough to assume that their portraits would override the art. How nice. But later, the colonial period gave rise to more and more such paintings. Royals, royal family members and noblemen, as also rich and affluent, wanted a painting made like this. This is Shankaracharya of Sringeri. And this picture is in Hyderabad Museum. The saints were also painted. Composition of the paintings. Being an iconic style, they had their own composition of a temple mandap with a grand freedom or seat in the middle, because these are mainly meant for worshipping. The following slide, I have tried to show a few models. These are the models by which the board, the canvas board was, composition was made on the canvas board. The design progressed according to the size of the board, and every small inch was covered with either embossed or gold or painted with many features and characters. Here we have shown the same composition, the picture with the same composition. These are panel paintings. Panel paintings, we have a center character and we have a central character here, and the related characters will be spread around like this. It can be very huge. This is a composition in which the central character and the additional characters and the accessories and elements with a sky view of the sky. There, sun and the moon are shown, or Gandharvas. So these were the compositions. And with the later influences of Mughals and Europeans, the paintings started to include chandeliers in the scheme, hanging above the mandap. Garlands of also show different motifs compared to the earlier period. Garlands evolved very much. The addition of Gandharvas or angels is attributed to the influence of Greek art. Now, the making of a Thanjavur painting. A wooden base is covered with a cloth and treated with tamarind seed paste and Arabic gum paste. This ensured a termite-free life for the painting. And locally abundant limestone was ground to a paste with neem gum and applied to give a three-dimensional effect. Originally, genuine uncut diamonds, rubies, and emeralds, along with the pure gold leaf, were used. Later, silver leaf treated with turmeric smoke to achieve a golden hue gained prominence. With time, synthetic foil sheets, and instead of gems, semi-precious stones, colored cut glass and plain glass painted on the reverse came to be used, along with mirrors. The earlier paintings were characterized by the use of pure colors, avoiding mixed tints. dominated the whole compositions of the picture, and specific colors for the principal figures as well as the background. Like she said, you know, Rama was always green. Blue was never used earlier. Later on, the blue came. And to show a dark complexioned deity, they used green. Like most of the Indian traditional painting, the size, skin color, and the dress all were portrayed as per the hierarchy of the position of that particular character in that composition. The following few slides, we'll see a quick view of the process of the paintings. And this is how it is being done in our center. I told you the board making a cloth pasted on the treated wooden plaque using a cloth is pasted, and then it is secured at the back, primed one or two times, and it is rubbed with smooth stone to give an even surface. And then the design is transferred. And then wherever required, stones are fixed. And then the raised, wherever we want the portions to be raised, they are done with the chalk powder paste and chalk powder with the neem gum paste. And the finished mugboard is coated with yellow oxide, mixed with gum water, then allowed to dry. It is used as an insecticide. And when it dries, gold foil sheets are fixed wherever required. And now the board is ready for painting. So painting is done according to the subject and the theme, allowing the painting. If you observe, the background color will always be either blue or red. But 2/3 of the board will be covered with one color and the rest of the either blue or red. It is reversed according to the character. And then the picture is, painting is ready to be framed and hung on the wall. While framing, the surface at the back of the painting is left open. See, due to weather conditions, the board contracts and expands. So, if that happens, then the top surface has a chalkboard paste and that muckwork will crack. This is the reason, if you are not very careful about packing it properly, this one important reason for paintings get cracky. Now we are coming to the contemporary scene. When we talk about contemporary paintings, one of our very famous Indian artists, Raja Ravi Verma, he not only introduced Western oil mediums in our country, but also having human, live human models for the paintings. He painted many devotional pictures which were later made into print and served as calendars. So many of these pictures became models for the early 20th century Thanjavur paintings. Gradually, many calendar works started to be copied and converted to Thanjavur style with stones and embossed work. Now we'll be seeing a few of the contemporary paintings. For reference purposes, I am considering the contemporary period from post-colonial to modern. One important thing to note is initially, the old paintings were not accessible to the public they couldn't see wall paintings beyond the region, mainly due to the lack of media exposure. It was not like that as now. And because one time, these were just God's pictures. People didn't know the value. Everyone had a few paintings in their homes, but they didn't realize the value. And these were just God's pictures on the wall. And many people did not maintain the pictures properly also. When the glass is broken, they just keep it as it is and put chandan, introduce moisture, thereby damaging the painting. For this reason, because they are not able to see how beautiful the old paintings are, that is the reason many of the contemporary artists of Israel, they don't know the significance of the specific style of depicting the characters. That is one important pulling down factor of this. But the things started changing. Not with the using the original Thanjavur style, but seeing old paintings. One notable name is Srimati Meena Muthaiah. She is from Chennai, who exposed this gorgeous painting style to the outside world with the intention of reviving the art form. She also started a residential school for this traditional arts in the whole manner in Chennai to offer training in the conventional style. Thus, the popularity and the demand to acquire gradually grew for these paintings. This painting, the left side painting, it's Rajamannar. The painting is in a mat in Thanjavur. And this is a Kovilur. It's also a Kovilur mat. Kovilur paintings. They are called Kovilur paintings. I hope you all are able to appreciate the old paintings. This, I don't know the date. I'm not sure about the date, but Lord Nataraja. Flanked by Sivagami and Ganesha, worshipped by Brahma, Vishnu, consorts and rishis. These are also 19th century. One is Panduranga and another is Kartikeya. These paintings belong to the current period. The individual elements originally used in larger compositions and the sacred symbols, they are done in this style. And from puja rooms and temples and puja rooms, it has started, they have started adorning the drawing room also all over the world. And this painting is the collection of, a few years back, Mr. Kuldeep Singh from Delhi, he opened his large collection of Thanjavur paintings, old paintings to the public. And now more and more people are sharing their personal collections of beautiful old paintings in the social media. Instagram, we can see a few of them in Pinterest and Instagram. So when it comes to the themes of contemporary art in general, it conveys the periodic concept of the painting and is collected by art lovers all over the world. Thanjavur style paintings as an art form is relevant even today because it portrays the present day scenario too, as it would at any given point of time, which include religious as well as social subjects, including portraits considering the demand of the present times, like the photo of a saint that girl showed on a video. But over a period of years, the methods and the process of creating this type of painting, they've evolved to a great extent. Demand and the urgency to mass produce have resulted in certain shortcut methods, thus foregoing the important step in preserving such works. increased value of old paintings has resulted in paintings made to look like antique ones. The lack of availability and cost of certain raw materials, combined with the elaborate nature of the process, the competition, commercialization, they have greatly contributed to this development. Also, not many have the time and patience to follow the elaborate processes involved in which brings down the quality of the product. All these directly or indirectly affect the genuine artist in the long run. Fake paintings are sold. A very customer person buys. Because of that, a genuine artist loses. The art of Thanjavur painting demands greater concentration, precision, and requires an artist, craftsman, and a sculptor all rolled together. There's always a debate as to whether it is a craft or an art. Having said that, coming to the contemporary art, unlike old times, these are not confined to a place or a region, but global. Now, the methods and materials are innumerable to experiment with. And it is encouraging to see that a few individuals and organizations and the regional government, they have come forward to create awareness to our rich treasure of art forms. These organizations, they conduct workshops through the traditional artists and in the process promote the art as well as the artists and craftsmen. I would like to end my talk with a few suggestions to bring about a change for the better. Learning Thanjavur style painting should be thorough, as a long-term course with a lot of scope for improving the basic skills of drawing and painting. That's very, very important. Understanding the basic concepts and using each and every step of the process of making these paintings should be insisted while imparting the training. An artist should practice well before becoming active commercially. Good artists should focus more on training the next generation, the conventional method. Many elements of India's diverse cultures, such as Indian religions, philosophy, cuisine, languages, particularly art, both visual and performing, have a profound impact globally. Foreign visitors are amazed at our traditional paintings and want to learn them in their true essence. With such a rich knowledge base, we should strive to promote and encourage all traditional art forms in general in order to help the artists and artisans as well as to spread it globally without dilution. That's very, very important. Many should come forward to learn this wonderful art form, especially youngsters. Art form of Thanjavur painting in its purity and the associated cultural aspects of a traditional art. They should do this with patience, showing restraint in exercising their artistic freedom without diluting the essence, and then share it with the next generation. Promoting the use of natural organic colors can be beneficial in propagating the idea of Make in India, providing livelihood for many, so that whoever wants to use them can have access. With this, we have come to the end of this presentation. Thank you all for being here and patiently listening to me and the innumerable online sources contributing to my content. I would like to extend my thanks to Ms. Radha and my guru, late Mr. T.S. Venkatraman, who helped me in my early learning, and now Ms. Nutan, who helped me with preparing this presentation. Thanks, Bangabasi College, for the opportunity given to me. Thank you, Ms. Tulika Chakravarti. Thank you. Namaskar.
Namaskar, madam, for your illuminating speech. Thank you. And of course, definitely, we are all thankful to you because Yeah, it's wonderful that you are so enthusiastic. You are so much like full of zeal. You are have yes. We should learn from you so many things, because ma'am, it's a very good sign actually, positive sign actually. At your age, people are like no, that should not be possible for me. That is not possible for me. Why I can't? I can't do like this and this and this. But you are just. You are, see, we all can see that you are so much, you have told me, no, I am not so much of net savvy and all. I don't know the techniques and all.
No, I try to learn. I never give up.
But I astonished, of course, madam, I surprised that you have just a very much like, yes, we have to learn so much of things from you, actually. So nothing is impossible. I am also telling my students that nothing is impossible. Impossible word itself, like I am possible. So nothing is impossible. Everything is possible now and all time. So thanks a lot, ma'am, for your nice deliberation. We came to know so much of things about, like, yes, of course, our rich heritage, our rich culture, our rich, so much of things. Now young generation must come forward and learn so many of things, and they can generate their own employment. Yeah. You know, today's yes. we are thinking for making Make in India thing, and like Atmanirbhar Bharat, and then Self-Reliant Bharat. So now our next generation should come forward and know the different things, that whatever we have much yes. of talent, we have much of treasuries. So these are rich treasures we have. So of course we have to explore those all treasures and go forward with them. Thank you a lot, ma'am. I'm asking Shomi Mukherjee, if we have any question.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, we have any question, Shomi?
Yes, ma'am. The comment section from Monica Kutia. The first question is, Chol Vansh mein anek mandir ka nirman kiya gaya.
Achha, translate kore bol.
Yeah.
Please translate it into English.
He asked that who made the mandir. One minute, ma'am. Who made the Brihadeshwara Mandir ka Chitrakala?
Please tell me the Hindi, then I would like. Please read out the Hindi one.
He asked, Chol Vansh mein anek mandir ka nirman kiya gaya, Rajaraj Chol ne Tanjore ka.
Yeah, continue.
I think some
network
issue. Yes, I think some network issue. Mihuli, can you read it out? Or it's in Hindi now. Let me see, ma'am. I think she has network problem.
Yeah, I'm not a historian. I'm actually mm-hmm. an artist, and out of,
yes, of course.
Curiosity, I learned so many things.
Let me see what is the question actually. I have to go to the YouTube link and then see what is the question. I think she has a like net issue. Then see.
What is the question? I think she has
$1 million question, it seems. Actually, ma'am, Mahipal Kutial asked that during the time of Chol dynasty, Raja Raj Chol Chol, that's created so many temples, built so many temples, like Brihadrameswar temple as well. The height of the temple is 180 feet, I think.
Yeah. The temple.
Who was the craftsman for building that temple? Do you know about?
See, during the course of he could not history. Have built it in his world one lifetime. It was continued and by many other following kings, and many people might have been involved in that.
ओके सो महिपाल जी मैडम ने कहा कि कोई किसी एक के माध्यम से मंदिर का निर्माण नहीं हुआ है. मंदिर चूंकि काफी सालों से बना है तो ये चूंकि इसमें बहुत सारे लोगों का इसमें श्रेय है और बहुत सारे लोगों ने इसमें पार्टिसिपेट किया है इस मंदिर को बनाने में. और
इट इज सेड दैट द किंग्स व्हेन दे वेंट ऑन वॉर विद अदर places, no? When they conquer a place and they get wealth, with that wealth they build some temples and monuments. It was in vogue. That practice was in those days. So it must have, it is a very big temple and it must have involved a few generations of this.
Okay, ma'am. Another question from the same person. He asked in the South Indian pattern, in the art, Mamalya Chitra Kala Shaili. Okay, Mamalya, there is any art pattern, Mamalya Chitra, like that only?
Pallava style of painting.
Yes, ma'am.
Mamallapuram is a place. The Pallava style architecture is there.
Okay. So he asks, what is that style actually?
Pallava style.
Okay, so Mahipal ji,
anything about Tanjavur painting?
Yes, please ask to the point. This is not like.
Somebody is asking.
Ma'am, yeah. Somebody is asking, S. Sathi Sanji, could you please explain about egg presses, madam?
Pardon?
Egg presses. EKPHRASIS.
What is
egg presses. Yes, it's not like. If you please ask question promptly and to the point, please. It's my humble request to you all. If any question, I think no more question is there. Okay, ma'am. Thanks a lot. Yes, ma'am. Yes. Please ask.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, please ask.
Yeah, tell me.
Yes, ma'am. In this generation, yes. Some students or some young age people like me, the students like.
Yes.
Tanjavur painting mein kisi ko agar interested hai.
Ask in English, please.
Yeah,
how they can create interest, right?
Yes,
is
ma'am.
That the question?
Yes, ma'am. How so, can they?
See, you don't need to create an interest in Tanjavur painting. They are shining gold and they attract so many people. Everybody wants to learn, but they don't have the patience to. They don't have the patience to learn. It's a long, drawn process. See, it is the two. Skills combined. It is one part is craft and one other part is painting. You should be proficient in both. So it is a long drawn process. Not everybody wants to learn Tanjavur painting, but you don't need to create interest. But they are afraid of the process. They want to learn it quickly, which is impossible.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, if somebody is completing the art and craft master degree from Gurukul institution, after that, how can he, if he is interested on Thanjavur painting, so how can she appeal for it?
Yeah, see, if you are already proficient in art, there is nothing to, nothing that does anything, nothing comes between you and the learning.
Yes.
So, see, what I am telling you is, if they have, even if they have the skill,
yes,
they don't have the patience. It's a long run process. Nowadays, they have studies and other extracurricular activities, and they want to include this, then it is lost. You have to be prepared for that a long time. See, if you break the practice, you won't get it properly. So, yes, with the art background, it is not very difficult. But it cannot be done as a crash course. You won't grasp the finer details of the art.
Yes, ma'am.
See, I showed you many paintings. Do you see the difference between the later paintings and the earlier paintings?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
ma'am. The use of colors. Nowadays, they want to experiment with so many other colors. See, previous painting, the earlier, all ancient, all art forms, Indian art forms, with that were done in earlier times, they are still attractive. Why? They use limited colors, and the composition was right. So everything was measured. Now we want to give freedom to our expression. So we just use any color and we want to experiment. Yes. And we don't get anywhere.
Yes, ma'am. As a art and craft is a field where we have to learn more things in, from the beginning of our career.
Yes, yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Thank you, ma'am.
I would like to request Soumi Mukherjee, if we have one more, I think we have one more question. Soumi? Soumi, can you hear me?
Ma'am?
We have one more question. Can you read it out?
Please, ma'am, give me a minute, please.
She seems to be having network problems.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Please ask.
The question is from Mohan Srinivasan.
Ah.
Yeah, why do, ma'am, could you listen me?
Yes. You see online?
He asked, why do they put white dots all over the Thanjavur painting?
Actually, white dots are put not only in Thanjavur painting. See, I observed in Cherial paintings of Andhra Pradesh. See, India was called the golden bird. We had so much of mineral and precious metals, pearls, everything. So, when we painted pictures earlier, we wanted to show all the aspects. So, white dots were meant to look like pearls. So in Kerala murals also we have, but what they do is they have the white surface and then they do it looking like pearls, white surface, they look like pearls. So it is not actually white dots, it is pearls shown with the white dots. It's a decoration.
I think no more question is there. Okay, ma'am. Yeah, thank you, Soumi. Thank you, Soumi, for your nice presentation. Thank you, thank you. Okay, ma'am. Thanks a lot. Thank you. Lots of thank you to ma'am. For making a wonderful presentation on the topic. Now, hopefully, our young generation have some thoughtful like thing that they have. They will definitely think about the topic. Yes, this is the thing. Many of us heard the name the Thanjavur painting and all.
Yes,
today's generation, very less people are there who know the things. There are how many paintings about the paintings, about the culture, about the, that's why we are arranging the lecture series on art, heritage, culture. We have arranged the two lecture series on heritage of India previously, and then this is a process of art. And then
actually,
again,
I heard one by that lady from Indonesia or somewhere East Asia.
Yes.
She was really good.
Yeah. Okay. You have attended, ma'am?
Yeah.
Okay. Next time, actually, we are also now preparing a three lecture series on culture of India.
Yeah.
From like dance, consisting dance and dance patterns, and then musical instruments and all. So we are again going to organize the 3 days lecture series. Chandan, are you willing to say something?
Yes, ma'am. I will request you, ma'am.
Yes.
Can you motivate our new generation student to come forward and learn about the art and craft, so that through their art and craft field from the beginning of their life, and now after the come in our age, they can interested on the Tajod painting, and they can involve, and they will serve more and give the knowledge to the people, not to forget about our culture, our heritage, art and craft, which is now the still the technology is coming, and some young generation, we are let's forget our these things. Can you motivate us, ma'am, so that can?
Yes, but the most important thing is the younger generation should fully know and understand our rich culture and heritage first, what we had earlier been. Then only they will have a liking to do follow the steps. First, we should give them all the history. That's why I dwelt more on the evolution part. No? It was so interesting how things evolved. There's a particular one painting style evolved. So they should know more about the history and our culture, heritage, importance of all that. Then they will be drawn towards this on their own. We don't need to do anything. And produce, show them good pictures, good paintings, and good artwork. Nowadays, show them good. Yeah.
Please carry on, ma'am.
That is how we can motivate them.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Yeah, I have given only a little bit of what I know. There's a lot more to see. Okay, thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you. Thank you very much, ma'am, for being with us. Thank you very much, ma'am. You're most welcome for Entitled and Son. We came to know so much of things. So at the end of the program, again, I'm remembering some lines from S.H. Raja. Yes, S.H. Raja. He said, a painting grows gradually. A painting grows gradually, organically.
Yes.
The bija, the seed, is the beginning of human life. This minuscule point, which is energy, condensed, can grow from its embryonic form to give birth to a whole series of paintings. Yes, of course. It is growing gradually. It is organically, it is growing. Nobody that become an artist, become an artist like in a day. It's a gradually, it's a process. As we heard about Madam is also like that much of thing she developed. She has developed herself. And then today, yes, we all can see the thing. Madam, at this age, it's very much, I must give compliments to the madam. Because yes, it's of course, ma'am, because at your age, I have seen so many of people in our in our day-to-day life, we have seen, we have noticed that what to do with these things. We are not so much of knowledge and all. And see, we have you, and then you are using and you were presenting your paper. Yeah, you have given your talk online. So yes, of course, it's very much commendable effort, madam. Very much commendable. And I think we must learn from you. We must, and then that people from your generation also must learn from you. They should come out from this.
It is a grace of God, actually. It's a grace of God.
And your will also, ma'am.
Yeah.
Your will also. Will is the most important thing. If you don't feel that, no, I will not, I can't do, and then all, then you can't.
But without His grace, I will not have the will.
Yes, yeah. Of course, grace is God is like definitely is a definite issue. But if you don't have the will, then you can't.
Yes.
So very much commendable effort, ma'am. Very much commendable effort.
Thank you
very much for being with us, ma'am. Now we are at the end of the program, and thank you all. Thank you, my team. Thank you, my NSS family. Thank you, Chandur, Miholi, Shomi, Ishita, all. Please, if possible, please on your videos so that ma'am can see all of you.
This is very bad. Video was very nice.
Yes, it was very nice to see. He is Chandan Rai, she is Somi Mukherjee, she is Isita Mukherjee, and where is my Miholi? Can you on the video, or you have?
It's okay.
Okay. No, actually, she is streaming the whole thing. She is the just backbone. Like, she is streaming the whole online thing. So that's okay. This is my team, ma'am. My full team, actually.
So, you have done a very, very good job. You are doing a very good job.
Not a team, actually. This is my family.
Family, yes.
Yeah. We are doing like that. It is my family, whatever. And they are always with me whenever what to do and when to do everything. Just because of them, I'm here. Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you very much, all. Thank you very much, Jitu sir, for being with us constantly and watch.
Thank you very much, sir.
Okay, sir. Bye. Yeah. Bye to all. Yes, ma'am. Please stay safe, stay strong. And
tomorrow, I will be watching tomorrow also.
Okay, ma'am. Sure. Sure, can join us. Okay, ma'am. Please welcome.